Hey YouTube, it's Rob here. Going to be reacting to one of my favorite songs ever, Bohemian Rhapsody. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. We got all sorts of stuff going on my channel. I've got a podcast basically called Casey Music Talk. If you want to check that out, we're talking with all sorts of musicians from around town and talking about all sorts of topics of how to make money in the music business and dealing with bandmates and practice tips and playing etiquette and all that kind of stuff. So go check that out on the channel. And so Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen, one of my favorite, probably top three favorite songs ever. And let's just get into it. Just lots and lots of stuff going on in this song. So I'll kind of stop it from time to time and kind of talk about what's going on here.
Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality.
Already you're hearing some wonderful, wonderful four-part harmony or multiple-part harmony. Just sounds really, really nice. I mean, almost, you know, definitely choir-like.
Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see.
Little high, little low.
Anyway, the wind.
Hear those background
goes,
vocals?
Doesn't really matter to me. To me.
And you hear that me, where they started low and came up high. That was really, really nice. This is nice. Freddie Mercury was a killer, killer singer, and you could hear they finally brought in the drums with this big intro. Hear him go up to that carry on. He went up high. He was, and he's an octave higher than what I can sing too. That God, his voice is just insane. Brought it down. Then go back to pushing again here on the second verse. You guys hear that ticket again? That for the shimmer or shivers? I mean, that's fun.
Goodbye, everybody. I've got to go. Gotta leave you all behind and face the truth. Mama,
sometimes I wish I'd never been born at all. Wow, that's a heck of a line right there. And then they finally bring in the, you know, kind of shreddy guitar solo here. Good riff. So they're going, you know, they had a straight ballad kind of stuff happening right there. Big intro, basically, I mean, choir sounding, and then they had their big ballad, and now they kind of go almost like music theater or something right here, which is the funnest part of the song, obviously.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Do you hear the very, very? Like there's this really top voice that I don't know how they did that. I don't know if that's Freddie or if they took some ability to put it up an octave on their computers that they had back then or whatever, but I know they did this off of tape, so they probably didn't. I don't know if they had the ability to do that or not, but that high part, very, very bright. I mean, that's just hilarious.
Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo,
Okay, so that little part right there, that's what they call a cascade. Oh, and so what you have to do on that is you have to have one part that goes oh, and then the other one starts right here and it sings oh, and then they have the third part oh, and so you have this it goes from like here, you know, and then they have to start each part and then hold it all the way through, kind of a tricky little section there.
Just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
Bismillah, no, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Hear that? Oh, at the top. So hear that again. That's really silly.
Oh, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah. We will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah. We will not let you go.
Let me go.
We'll not let you go.
Let me go.
We'll not let you go.
Never let me go.
There's that cascade again.
Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia.
Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub. The devil put aside for
me, of course.
For me, for me.
Then they go to straight rock right here. His microphone is weird. He doesn't have the bottom to it. It's just the stand and he holds it. I've never seen anybody do that before. That's really crazy where you don't have the bottom, but that allows him to obviously move around on stage like crazy. Guitar. There's a really nice little guitar part there. Yeah, so that song had so much stuff going through it. So again, to map it all out to understand what's going on is you had the chorus part at the beginning, you had the ballad section, you had the guitar, you know, the kind of ballad guitar solo part. Then you had the you had the like music theater go part where they're going back and forth with all of those vocal parts. Then you had the rock part, and then you had the kind of come down at the end. So there's six sections going through that song. You could tell that these guys were inspired by, you know, that, I mean, that's straight up classical rock, basically, like classical music put of rock put together. There's sections and ups and downs, and they just didn't, I mean, they again totally outdid themselves on that song. I mean, that's one of the best rock songs ever made as far as I'm concerned. And as you can tell, if you've watched some of the stuff on my channel, this is the kind of stuff that is my favorite kind of music to listen to. Stuff that's deeply rock in the heart, but in the head has a little bit more, you know, complexity to it, and songs that are a little more thought out. And obviously that is, to me, that is more like classical music than it is like rock. And you know, you have guys that are able to map that out musically, but you also have you know, Freddie Mercury, that's a absolutely fantastic singer. And I would urge you to go check out, there's one really famous live version of this song that is fantastic. And Freddie does a good job of like changing up the melodies a little bit and really adds to the song. And and so, you know, I really like these bands that really take different themes of different genres and all putting them together. And that's kind of the fun of it, is it's really hard to categorize. And so that's one of my favorite songs ever. Bohemian Rhapsody is absolutely fantastic. And it's just kind of amazing that there haven't been this as many songs like this in rock history. I mean, they're out there, but this is just, you know, one for the ages. And I'm sure if Freddie didn't, you know, didn't pass away and didn't kind of get sick there at the end from AIDS, that I'm sure they would have had a long career. Anyway, so there you go. There's Bohemian Rhapsody. And hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you next time.